Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. For those of you who are new here and don't know who I am, hi, my name is Jania, not Janaya. And if you didn't know that, now you do know that. I just wanted to come on here to basically, well, I already made this announcement. If you follow me on Instagram, if you have me on LinkedIn, and if you turn on your YouTube community tab posts, you already know this announcement. But I'm just gonna say, I remember like a while back, I was basically just looking for internships. And if you followed me on my YouTube channel, you would see like ever since probably spring of last year, I was looking for internships. I ended up with an internship at BronxNet TV in New York City, and I was able to become a TV producer intern. I was able to produce television interviews with one of my favorite YouTubers, Ashawn Wahl. And she's a Christian content creator who posts about faith, lifestyle, beauty, fashion, and etc. So to be able to produce an interview on national television and have it shown multiple times on air and have her be able to collaborate with me, it was like, a dream come true. I was able to produce another interview with Grammy Award winning, two-time Grammy Award winning musician who's just in like several bands and everything, and he's just literally like a legend. So I was able to do that and learn about the teleprompter stuff, CG graphics, and being able to write scripts and informationals and everything. And I did that in my 2022 fall semester from September to December of last year. And that was my first internship. And I'm so grateful and so blessed. I'm also just so grateful that God has blessed me with another internship, which is also the good news. And I am an intern for NBCUniversal. For those of you who don't know NBCUniversal, that's basically like NBC in a way. It's underneath this parent company called Comcast. And I just wanted to make that announcement and put a video up here just so I could look back at memories and everything. I am working in the business called Entertainment Networks. Basically, in NBCUniversal, there's different entertainment networks. So I work with Bravo TV. They're the ones known for a bunch of reality TV shows, and you could check that out. I'm an entertainment digital video intern, so I get to work with producers and editors and create content and edit and do some stuff for reality TV. And honestly, I'm so blessed and I'm so excited. I did apply to NBCUniversal during spring of 2022. I don't know if I applied during December 2021, but I know I did apply one time. I got rejected the first time. I applied again. I applied to Disney, Paramount, Warner Bros., Nickelodeon, NBC, all that stuff. And I was able to go through several interviews. And a few weeks ago, I found out my new assignment, and it was to work for Bravo TV and be able to get the internship that I have now. And I'm so grateful and so blessed. I know that the onboarding and first week experience was so amazing. And I'm getting to network with a lot of lovely people and like-minded individuals who are very diligent and creative and innovative. And honestly, this video isn't only just to share the good news, but I just want to talk about God as well. And I'm not gonna only talk about, what God has done. I'm not gonna only praise God for what he's done. I'm gonna praise God because of who he is. God is somebody who's never gonna break a promise. He is a man that cannot lie. While I'm seeing, a bunch of people getting internships, God was like, you know what? You hold your head up high. I hear you. I hear you. Don't be discouraged. You need to wait. And I was thinking, before I made this video, I was thinking about the number seven. The number seven came to mind. And if you read the Bible, you know that the number seven is just, it's really impactful. It's really meaningful. The number seven is basically the number of completion. I was thinking about how in 2016, if you follow me on Instagram, you already know this, but in 2016, I was able to work with NBC producers and stuff and be on a television show called Give, which was from NBC TV. It's like a reality TV show. I guess like a nonprofit organization. They go to different organizations and interview people and stuff and just give the people scholarships and the program scholarships. I was in a TV episode, and I remember before being on that TV episode, I was in this drama program in Manhattan, and I was very into acting. I was involved in a lot of musical theater and all those plays and all that stuff. There was one time where I was in the high school program and we had to write a bunch of like monologues as an exercise because we're creating our own characters and creating our own plays. And then my character was Cinderella and I had to do a scene from Into the Woods. So I wrote my own original monologue. And my director, she thought it was really good. Weeks later, right? I'm coming back home from praise dance class, right? And you know, my parents are coming from Bible study. So we're coming home from church. I get an email saying that we're gonna be on a television show and everything. And I was saying to my mom, should I be on it? And my mom's like, yes. And then my director and the theater program, the musical theater program founder and producer, they came to me and said, we loved your monologue. Please go and perform it in front of the camera for NBC. And I was like to my mom, should I do it? Because I was so shy and so quiet and so reserved. And my mom was like, yeah, you should do it. So I was able to do it and also come in early to be interviewed. And we had a special guest when we were filming. Basically, they came to film how the program functions, what we do, songs we sing, how we prepare for plays and interviewing, just like those type of reality TV shows, you know? The special guest was Cynthia Erivo. She basically acted as Harriet in the movie, and she also is gonna be the next Elphaba in the Wicked movies that are coming out in 2024 and 2025. So I didn't know who she was at the time. I wasn't familiar with the color purple, and she's also known for that. And I was able to perform my monologue in front of her, and she gave me some tips, and they interviewed her, and she was saying how she was so inspired by me. And this was when I was 14, and this took place in 2016. When I tell you how God just, he's such a miracle worker, he's a promise keeper. You know, the other day I'm thinking about the number seven, and I was like, wait, the number seven is the number of completion. So in 2016, when I was 14, I basically was like filming for an NBC television show. The episode came out in 2017 before I turned 15, but the experience was in 2016. 7 years later, I find out that I'm gonna work for NBC Universal. I'm gonna be an intern for them. I'm gonna work with the company basically. And this is when I'm 21. I'm 21 right now in 2023. So I'm thinking, well, God, seven? Okay, there's 7 years, but 7 years of what? So if seven's the number of completion, then I'm starting to realize and get a revelation. I had 7 complete years of waiting. I had 7 years of waiting. And then once that 7 years complete, then I go back to work with the company again. Isn't God good? Like, I just realized that like a few days ago. And I just feel so blessed and so honored and so loved because, you know, God shows that He's not ignoring you. Whenever God decides to do what He does, it's because it's in His perfect will and plan and way. And we just have to trust Him. So I thank God truly for just blessing me with this opportunity, and it's only up from here. And I know I should never forget about God as I go way up to the top, as I work my way to the top. And He's my firm foundation. He's the solid rock on which I stand. And Jesus is always just interceding on our behalf, and He loves us, and He wants us to have a relationship with Him. And this just proves that, you know, God never takes His hand off of the righteous. He never takes his hand off of his people. He's always looking out for his children. He's gonna stand by his word, even if it means waiting and worshiping him during the wilderness season, which is the truest, like deepest form of worship. Even if it means pain is happening in the night, but joy comes in the morning. Even if it means, you know, you feel as if God's not hearing you, but in reality, He is. Like, God always hears you, and He's not going to forget about you. He's going to stand by His word. And while you wait, wait in love. And instead of asking God why, or how come, just know all things are going to work together for your good. God is an intentional God. He is going to stick by His word. And Jeremiah 29, verse 11 talks about how He has good plans for us. And this just shows that this is an example of me not knowing in the past what God was doing until later on I will know what He's doing. This is to encourage you. You may not know what God is doing right now. You may not know why God is doing what He's doing or why such and such is happening and why this is His will, but just know that there's always a reason behind it. When it comes to pain, there's always purpose behind it. When it comes to success, there's always failure before. When it comes to blessings, there's always the messing before. When it comes to triumphs, there's always the tests, trials, and tribulations that come before. I say all this to just praise God, not for only what He's done, but for who He is, but also just to encourage you that even if you do get rejected from somebody or something or whatever, just know that it could be God's redirection plus protection. Just know that everybody goes through rejection in some point in their life. And God always has a good plan for you. You just have to do your step and do your part and keep Him first. So God is just so good, and He's so awesome. I remember seeing something, I think, on social media where it said that sometimes you think you don't hear God, but the teacher doesn't talk while you're going through a test. Something like that. I don't know. Listen, I don't know, y'all. But God is just, He's so good. He is so good. My heart goes out to everybody who's, been dealing with the whole Canada fire situation, the Canada wildfire situation, and to all the people who live in the different states or countries or whatever that are affected by the smoke. Because I know I'm in New York City and it really affected us for a few days. And just keep your eyes on the Lord. Don't only have hope, have faith. Because faith is basically hope activated. Sometimes when you have hope, you function on the ifs and the maybes, but God doesn't function that way. So when you have faith, you please God and you're believing in the unseen and you're basically training yourself how to see in the spirit. So that's my announcement. Just wanted to share it with you guys and just prove that, God is so good and I'm just an example of how good He is. Like I know even when it came to my testimony, I'm living proof that God is good and He's not finished with me yet. And the same applies to you. You might be questioning some things or going through some things or confused or, might be worrying, but God sees it all. God knows it all. He hears it all. And it's not your permissive will that has to be done. It's God's will that has to be done. And when you take things into the matter of your own hands, you lose sight on what God has in store for you. So, I pray that this inspires you and encourages you. Don't compare your journey to mine. Don't compare your journey to anybody else's. We all have to start from somewhere, and we all have to at least at some point work our way to the top. My journey and my walk with Christ might seem different than yours. We're all different individuals. We all are different souls. And God deals with us all in different ways. I just want to say that no matter what, God sees it all, He hears it all, and He knows it all. So be blessed, be encouraged, and I hope that this story and this experience inspires you. God's really just done some amazing things in my life, and I think a lot about my testimony and just, how He saved and delivered me from a lot of things, and also talking about a lot of the things that I went through, and then just showing that, God's not finished with me yet. And if you're alive and you're watching this, He's not finished with you either. He's not done. There's still an opportunity for you to grow. There's still an opportunity for you to go in that secret place and seek His face there's still an opportunity for you to have a relationship with him, and there's still an opportunity for you to become the best you that you can be. I believe that with God's help and with Jesus being the mediator, with the Spirit being our teacher and our guide, we can move mountains and we can achieve the impossible. Just know that, once again, rejection is redirection and protection, and God loves you so much, and so do I. I hope this encourages you. Be blessed.